welcome back to the Blind LP of Valkyria Chronicles. I am Buddy Bison, and I have not done anything since the last episode. I have not once again grinded my ass off. I am very honest with you. I'm not being sarcastic. So let's do this episode and rock it.
Here is your mission brief.
Okay. So Empire's defenses will likely be spread across both banks of the river. So this seems to be... okay. This doesn't seem too bad. You'll strike from the south and muscle your way into Fousen as quietly as you can. Fousen is built along a canyon, so the lay of the land is highly varied. Check your map carefully in command mode. It barely gives me any idea of elevation. Your objective is simply for you to reach the destination point, Lieutenant. On contact on the inside won't do much camp without you there. Find them at the labor camp as soon as you're in. Inside the city, you'll find searchlights on the watch in trolley carts you can ride along the rails. Those lights spot you. Expect mortars or sniper bullets to start raining down. Tread carefully in there. Darkness will be your best friend out there, but it will also mean limited visibility. Keep your eyes peeled. Okay. So, Welkin dies, and enemy occupies Galley's base camp. 20 turns pass. Welkin reaches the destination. So, that means he's in his tank, which kind of sucks. Okay, so if he's in his tank, I need Carl. I'm gonna take Largo for extra move. Rosie should do fine. I'm gonna take Alicia. And she has night vision, which is good. He also has night vision, which is good. He has nocturnal. Okay, so I'll take both of these, because they also are the ones with the good weapons. Okay, so this team should possibly be one of the best teams I've ever had.
Questions? Let's get started. I wish you good luck and happy hunting.
The only possibly negative thing is Largo's there, but he gives me a move.
Our top priority is to get to the rendezvous point. Squad 7, move out!
And having more moves is always useful when you have a tank, simply because it allows you to...
Well, this is Fousen. Looks like a complicated layout.
Let's move carefully here. We don't want to be spotted.
We're in a goddamn tank. How are we not going to be spotted? So... presumably we have to go, like, through here? Like, this way? Like, I'm not absolutely sure, so I'm gonna use Alicia. Try and scout it out a little bit.
Enemy unit spotted!
Where? Over there?
I
guess.
I wouldn't advise
okay.
Lieutenant Gunther, you may be able to move unseen using the trolley cars around town. Their path is fixed. They can only fit one person, but they may get you behind the enemy.
I guess I'll use it for the sake of it.
Enemy unit spotted!
Keep that cover fire coming!
Okay, so this is a sniper. Okay, so just drop me right there. Okay, that shouldn't be bad. Leave her here, because say that sniper tries to move, probably gonna just immediately get killed by
on the move now.
by the interception.
It's a big enough target.
Fortunately, cannot see anyone. Gonna have to move him anyway. Okay, let's start moving the tank.
Enemy sighted!
Tank command, move out!
working. I'll move the tank again. Just because, since I have to get Welkin to the end, I need to essentially try and move him as much as possible. Oh, god damn it. Fuck it. I don't like how it doesn't save you on the ammo that you were previously on. That annoys me that I just used it.
I'm not from dead. I can see your... my throat feels all hairy.
Ugh, god. You have a metal allergy.
Stay close out there.
Loses health when he's on a goddamn thing of metal.
I'll make it work.
I'm not going to be able to pass the bridge with him right now. Okay, I'm going to move Marina.
It's injured. Remember to use Ragnate.
And I've got two more moves left. I'm actually just gonna save it. Because it'll allow me to move the tank another time. Or use Alicia to get rid of some people. Oh wow, she got turned around. You guys an idiot. But I'm surprised he did because I was behind him, so I didn't think that he would be able to just do that. Because I thought he had to detect me. Sometimes the accuracy gets me, but I wasn't really expecting it. He gets health back on turns, so. So that seemed like a short move, not very long. Okay. So I'm hoping. So what I want to do. Use
now.
Oscar. I'm hoping he can just call the trolley. Nope. Okay, cool. So it's a one-time use thing. And I used it on a scout. A unit whose movement is already superior to that of most other things. Perfect.
Entering combat. Enemy sighted. Enemy sighted.
Be careful. If they get those searchlights on you, you'll be dodging mortars. Avoid the lights at all costs. If they find you, take evasive action immediately. What is your situation?
Need to know where the searchlights stop and start.
All troops, advance!
Both of them.
Nice work! Keep taking them down!
So, I'm going to be trying to push through.
Maintain your lines!
I don't know why I was trying to be stealthy in a fucking tank. Might as well just try and push through.
Here we go.
God, the movement gets so... like... God damn.
Tank command, move out.
These this tank shell on this guy.
Now!
Like, he's still in the blast radius a little bit. And for some reason, my treads are absolute shite. What the fuck happened? Or, no, that's his AP. Ugh, I'm an idiot. Guess I'll move up a little bit more. Clear the... Oh, okay, just shoot that thing. I wish there was more of a destructible environment in this game. I'm gonna use Alicia to take out that sniper.
Enemy unit spotted.
Ooh, there's two. Okay. I'll take out. Okay, take out that sniper from here because he gives him a move. Run past this one.
Somebody go swap those flies down.
I won't run past, I'll go here. Yeah, anchoring phase. I didn't even see that. Okay, so that means I'm going to need to be moving up my mechanic.
No.
What?
Sorry.
Are you serious? What? Where do you even one-shot me from? What? Yeah. Okay, cool.
Our top priority is to get to the rendezvous point.
Okay.
Squad 7, move out!
I don't even understand that. I guess I'll move up with a mechanic. This time I'll try not to get the... Oh my god. Very...
Hostile sighting.
Furious tapping.
He is full of smog.
Fire!
Yeah, just take him out.
Enemy.
So I've got time to deal with that. This time, I'm going to try and do is I'm going to try. That's not even good. I was going to try and get a sniper up here, but they're only going to have three rounds. So I'm probably going to put Alicia up there again.
That won't slow me down.
Poison tolerance, cool. I mean.
Wow, just look at all the steel.
This guy likes metal, which is nice.
All units report in.
So two tank moves equals about one mechanic move, which is nice. And okay.
Moving out.
Squad leaders, report your status.
Yeah. Enemy sighted.
Okay, so. Guy right there. And now this time, since I haven't wasted any moves on the snipers, have more to use with her.
Enemy sighted! Enemy sighted!
Then I'm gonna use that to its fullest.
Moving out!
These guys, I don't even have to aim at the head. I can just aim at the body, guarantee the hits because the gun is so powerful.
Enemy units spotted.
Great. Seems rather unsafe of them to put just mines in the middle of a road that presumably has industrial work going on it. But luckily, Alicia has quite a bit of health. It can just tank some stuff. I'm gonna end. And where I am right now is pretty good. So I'm gonna save, because I am not above save scumming at this point. Because I've already lost, like, once. So might as well make sure that I can come back at an easier point. Save that turn so I can do a little bit better next time. So I'm hoping I can take the shock troopers out again with moved into the middle of the thing. Okay.
Entering combat.
So
now.
Wow, that was very accurate.
Target silenced. Head to the next one.
Enemy sighted.
Don't look down. You'll only panic.
Enemy sighted.
Okay, so I believe the way... I'm not sure how they want me to advance. There's like a tank right there. And I'm guessing it was the mortar that got me last time. So I'm gonna move up a little in there. I'm not gonna move the tank again. But I will move Carl. Carl. Fortunately, the range isn't good enough.
Keep abreast of the situation.
Okay. Anything I can do? No. Okay. Look like something that might be interactable.
Don't look down. You'll only panic.
That's some grass.
Enemy unit spotted.
Man, that's a tank.
Permission to advance granted.
What I can do. Damn it. Oh well. Okay. So, because I'm not going to be moving anymore at this turn, I'm going to keep tapping past it.
I'm taking heal myself.
And I was lucky enough to proc that, so I'm probably going to get to full.
Keep moving, go. The destination's up.
Because I would want to go gutsy and get here, but this tank would be disastrous. So I'm gonna try this. Fucking Carl. I didn't even move. Okay, took those guys out. That just makes it easier.
Target silenced.
General.
It's a big enough target. Try not to miss it.
Team is going to be running at like full those.
Entering combat.
So, going to here. So this one is doing a loop, and that one just goes up and down the street.
Please continue advancing. The target is up ahead.
Now's your chance. Have you sighted them yet?
Entering combat.
Penetrating enemy lines.
Make it work. Might as well attack from here while I can. And I am going to do
I'll do my best.
Carl. Because right now his, like, he's not moving at all. And these guys are really just back here because, like, they're, I can't do anything with them for the most part. I'm trying to land it on the bridge. Like that.
Have you sighted them yet?
Just to do some damage, maybe. Get their treads out. Okay, that's fine. So they seem to have someone.
Okay. Here we go.
Now I'm gonna try and time it so I can get out. But I need to wait for that to come back the other way. And the one that I like, the one that I don't think I can avoid. Is that light right there? The one that. Although it does seem to be a little bit different in that it flashes in and out. It's not just always there. Unless that's just. Oh, you stop. Okay. I'm gonna take care of this thing right here. Because I don't want it impeding my. Later.
Try to conserve ammunition when you can.
So that one goes, and then it comes back.
Strike them first.
And this one comes to about there, and goes back out that way.
Go! The destination's up ahead.
Enemy sighted.
Got to end current action.
Entering
gonna
combat.
Move. Tank again.
Minor damage sustained.
That.
Good. That
makes going. And I'm actually going to push on again. So that should be good. Now what I need to do is I need to take Alicia and
can't beat the smell of fresh soil out
there. Need to run her over to kill this Lancer. So this Lancer is dangerous, because he'll be able to take out my tank.
Nice work. Keep taking them down.
Now, I believe that, yeah, that's the trolley that'll take me back around.
The air seems smoggy.
But
enemy units spotted.
I want to capture that point. God damn it. So they have a scout and a shock trooper. Because once I get that, I'll be able to deploy some more people. And that's the goal right there. So once I can get the tank through and whatnot. But first of all, I need to get Carl.
I'll do my best.
Heal tank up.
Thank you.
Please be sure to check your ammunition.
Over. And I guess what I'll start doing is having these people retreat. That way I don't have to use more turns.
I'll knock him dead.
I
can see your punch line from a mile away.
Once
nice,
I take,
huh? Just us guys.
Them. I'm gonna leave Rosie and Largo out. Because they give me moves. Like extra moves to get through with. And I'm not actually going to make this last one retreat, because I'll see that as just a waste of a move. Really?
Moving out.
Okay. So with her. So what that did was it at least got him out of the, it got him uncrouched.
My turn, okay?
Save, because I'm in a good place right now.
Turn,
use her
okay.
Again. Luckily, I have 7 shots in this gun. So, just took out of one of their turns. Occupy this camp. And then... ooh, that's a Lancer. I'm probably not going to be able to get him. What I am going to do is I'm going to get Nancy and just have 2 scouts out. And then... oof. Don't think this Lancer is going to come all the way up and attack him. And I have just saved. So, well, actually, I'll save again because in a different spot. Because I just took this spot and I should be able to take him. But I'm not going to be able to get anywhere. So I'm actually going to try and take him out with Carl. Grenade him out. Okay, so now he is successfully out of the grass. So I'm going to end right there. And I'm going to take her. Did a good damage, a good amount of damage on that guy. I'm going to use my last move to move slightly closer so my next bullets have a better chance of hitting them. Okay. For a sec, I thought I was going to miss every single one of those shots on his head. Okay. So that's good. Scout up here in case I need it. But what I will do is I don't know what's behind enemy lines, so I'm going to ride this because it puts me back here. Now I can't interact with that, so the only way to go is up here. But
I wouldn't advise looking down. You'll lose your nerve.
Enemy unit spotted.
Okay. Might as well try and hit him from here. Simply because I have the move. I have the shot, essentially. I could have tried to get them both out in one turn by aiming, like, okay, in between them and hoping that the, like, the variance of the bullet would be able to take out both of them. But I'm not too worried about it. I'm prioritizing taking out this sniper because he's probably the one with the greatest chance of taking me out, other than the tank itself.
Enemy unit neutralized.
But now what I am going to do, because there doesn't seem to be any other people up here, is I'm going to take our tank out of danger by hopefully killing these Lancers. Okay. That's good.
I'm impressed, but not surprised. Don't look down. You'll only panic.
Enemy sighted.
Oh, okay. So I gotta take that guy out. I'm glad I moved over because if I didn't, okay, he may have got me from behind. So it kind of sucks because I wanted to essentially preserve this movement's turn. But what I'm gonna do is I'm going to attack from here. Take out this final Lancer.
Don't even think of dodging.
Wow, undodgeable shot. Misses the first two shots. Good, good. That's a good title right there.
Good work. Keep it up.
Okay. Now, this last one is going to be an experiment. Actually, I want to check. So versus person is 100, versus armor it's 950. Now normal versus armor is multiple hundreds. So I'm probably not going to be able to do anything. I was going to experiment and be like, oh, maybe I'll try and shoot it from the back with,
here we go,
with Alicia, because I was able to take out the armored car. But I'm guessing the armored car was given purposefully lower defense because you weren't allowed to use lances and whatnot. So, just the normal. Okay.
Entering combat.
Lastly, I'm going to use Carl.
Just look at all the steel.
I'm just gonna pop him right behind the tank to heal up any damage that gets taken.
Damage minimal.
Yeah.
Damage minimal.
Because now I'm not too worried about any mortars or whatnot. Because the end is right there.
Entering combat. Fire!
Okay, take out that guy. They don't have any places to get reinforcements from.
Damage minimal. Yeah.
Thing about the mortars is they're essentially, there's no way to get past that specific mortar because it's on the bridge and you're going through it with a tank. But at this point in time, you're just supposed to kind of roll through.
Entering combat.
So it's turn six. I wonder what rank that is, because I feel like it would be pretty hard to go faster than six turns just based on limited amounts of tank
movements. Complete. We're in.
Possibly five, depending on... Yeah. I'm guessing it's five because I did use a few turns making those people retreat and then calling them up at that prior one. Okay, so... Got another medal coming, because I did get another achievement. So... First of all, let's save, because... don't want to have to go through that again. Let's go to headquarters. We're doing pretty good on time. Audience hall. Yep. That's an elaborate one. Order of the Holy Shield awarded.
Furthermore, for your squad's exemplary performance in the final battle, this royal award.
Thank you.
Huh. Galleon 1R, 1 received. Huh. Mags MR, M1R received. I wonder if something broke. Maybe they think I'm on like New Game Plus or something. GS 1R. Yeah, I'll have to see if these are like really good weapons. Of course, the DLC weapons might be better anyway. And I got two of that one gun because, most likely due to, mechanics and scouts using the same weapon. Okay, so I got 37,300. I use scouts a lot, and this will get him more HP, so. Okay. And might as well put that in snipers because they're essentially my second favorite unit, because they just feel good to kill people with. Unfortunately, they have limited ammo, so you need them at a base or near a mechanic. Let's go R&D. Weapons, anything. No. Firepower, might as well. Clip size up 5. Give me 25 shots. Yeah, I'll go for that. Because you're using a machine gun. While damage is important, I would rather have more shots of less damage than more damage per shot. Because 6 times 5 is 30. So, because this does 20 shots at 26, and this one does 25, so the difference is 5. So you're losing 30, you have 30 damage difference if this were to shoot 20 shots. But then you also do 21 times 5, and that's over 100. So I might actually equip people with this. Or might not, I don't know. Anti-tank lances. Accuracy boost, I guess. Not that my do this. Because these are anti-personnel, the flamethrowers, without a doubt. Okay. Just going through menus. Okay, so better machine gun. Which is nice. Radiator upgrade. I might as well buy it. I'm not gonna equip it because I don't. My engine block isn't big enough. And I understand it's meant to be like, okay, you have to pick what type of style you want your tank to have. Let's go to the squad barracks and see about those weapons. So, he's using a normal Galleon S2. But Galleon 1R. Yeah. So basically, the DLC ones are just a lot better. Like they're chapters ahead. Because you can see this is 3, this is 8. So 1R seems to just have better aim and better damage. It doesn't seem all that impressive. I guess I'll equip it on him. I mean, it doesn't... tell that it's not anything really special. Yeah, and this one's just straight better. Then I gotta go to Rosie, equip her thing, because yeah, it's the range that made the sniper trial not doable, because she needs to have a decent range to shoot across that crevasse. And Largo, I haven't done his thing, so yeah, better range, a little less damage. I'd rather just keep this, because range doesn't matter if all I'm doing is running up to someone and shooting them, essentially in the butt. And this is just going to be... Yeah, they give me... So, 7. So it has more range, less damage, just in general, but it has better aim. But this thing's zoom is so powerful that it doesn't even matter. Yeah, so they just gave me nice stuff that isn't really better than what I have. Weaponry tab has been updated. I'm going to go to tab. Let's go look at the decorations. So, got this one. Based on Valkyrian Shield, it's presented to a squad who has earned victory without a single casualty. Really? Okay. Yeah, I guess I didn't lose anyone on that map. Which I find honestly impressive that means every other victory. I wonder if they don't count the DLC as missions. Or they only count towards like kill-based ones. Because there were a few of the times where I went through the DLC ones without anyone dying. Or getting felled. So let's go to episode select. Right now we're at 47. I'll save. And we can at least do this cutscene. Figure out like why we were even doing this. Well, I mean more than why, but the interaction.
What brings you folks here? And how'd you get in?
Welkin Gunther is my name. I was told there was a militia sympathizer here.
Well, you heard right. Welkin, I'm your guy. I'm Zaka. It's nice to meet you. Hey, Pumpkin. I've got to talk some adult stuff with these folks. Would you be a good girl and go to bed for me?
Okay. Good night.
She's sweet. She your kid's sister?
No. Both her parents died a while back. They were victims of torture.
Torture? That's just horrible.
Listen, we have a lot of work to do. Follow me, let's get started. As you can see, Fausen's factories are located on the canyon's edge, split between an upper and lower level. There's an armored train that services those factories. It moves on rails built into the upper level, shooting downward.
If it's up there, it's completely out of our range. How do we attack it?
Glad you asked. We take it down with this little wonder. It's a Ragnite bomb. I made it myself. I've been sneaking spare parts from under the Empire's watch for weeks. I can guarantee its power.
You think one bomb's gonna blow this thing up?
I'm not proposing we use it on the train. We use it on this.
I get it. We take out the rails. Then the train drops into the canyon from the bridge.
Exactly. You can leave the setting of the bomb to me. I want all of you to provide a diversion so I can get in there and attach the package to a strut. Once I've wired it and gotten a safe distance away, I'll give you a signal. Then you'll detonate it and destroy the bridge.
Right. Sounds good.
So we're doing a classic bridge destruction.
Did you have any questions about the mission then?
No, I got it.
Is there something else?
Forget it.
Oh, I get it now. You're wondering if you can trust me because I'm a Darkson, yeah? If you don't mind me asking, tell me something you like.
What?
Something you enjoy. There's gotta be something, right?
Singing, I guess. I like to sing and listen to other folks.
Musician, huh? Nice. I like to sing too. Nothing beats a nice tune and a little stroll. Music can pick you up or make you cry. Anthems can drive a whole country to war. That's the great thing about music. Variety. Every song is different, but it's all good.
Yeah, I guess so. So what are you getting at?
If you appreciate diversity in music, why hate all the Darksons?
What?
There's plenty of races in the world. Each has its traits, but people are all unique. Just like with music. They've all got their good points. Well, I think so, anyway.
Singing's more fun with a chorus, right? I agree, Zaka.
There are over 30,000 kinds of beetles in the world, each with its own characteristics. It's the same for us, too.
Ugh. Another one of the boss's nature talks.
Beetles? Well, that's a new one. I never heard a man compare people to bugs in a good way before. I'd have to agree, though. Bickering won't do us any good. Let's try to make nice.
Okay. The operation begins tomorrow at dawn. I want everyone ready for combat.
Okay. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to end the episode here, and we'll start next time on that cutscene and the mission. Because this one seems like a very good intro into the mission, and then we'll do the mission and then finish the chapter. So, with that, I'm going to end the episode here. I hope you all have a very nice day.